Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Osteo Med presentation. This is an e-learning module on osteology. The topic is Norma Frontalis, part 3. Here we cover the nasal region. In the previous two parts, namely part 1, we covered the frontal region. Part 2, we covered the orbital region. And now, in this part 3, let's look at the nasal region of Norma frontalis. We start with the same slides we saw in the previous part 1 and part 2. There, we divided the skull roughly into three areas: frontal, naso-orbital, and oral. Now let's concentrate on this area, naso-orbital, and more specifically, let's look at this region. Let's call it the nasal region. Now that is the area roughly which we are going to concentrate on. Corresponding to the skull, here is a plain x-ray. You can see here the nasal region again outlined corresponding to what you saw in the previous slide. Now, a few things in a radiology or in an x-ray which is in the near vicinity of the nose, I am showing right above the nasal cavity. You can see the frontal sinus, the upper two flashing arrows, and right on either sides of the nasal cavity you can see the maxillary sinus, one on each side, right and left sinus, that is the lower two flashing arrows. Now this is the part that actually presents, that is the area, That's the nasal region or the nose region that's presenting in Norma frontalis. The arrows have been placed at the periphery of this area, at the periphery of the nose, and this is the area, this binding area is the anterior nasal aperture, also known as the piriform aperture. The actual nose is slightly different from this because septal and lateral cartilages are there which gives the final shape to the nose, and then it's covered by the skin. Next, at the upper part here, the topmost flashing arrow is the nasal bone, the lower border of the nasal bone. In other words, we are looking at the boundaries of this anterior nasal aperture. The lateral boundary is found by 1. The body of the maxilla, and 2. Its superior continuation known as the frontal process of the maxilla. Next, lower down, the base of this nasal triangle or the nasal region, there is the two maxillae fuse, and the upper edge of this fused area is the anterior nasal spine. Below the anterior nasal spine, that's the end of the nasal area, but you can see a ridge, that is the intermaxillary suture. Next, right in the middle of this nasal aperture, you can see the bony septum of the nose. So that is the medial wall of each nasal cavity, right and the left. It divides the nasal cavity into roughly two parts, a right nasal cavity and a left nasal cavity. This septum, the bony septum, there are two main components visible in this view. The upper part is the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid, also known as the septum of the ethmoid bone, and lower down, the larger one, the vomer bone. On the lateral side, projecting into the nasal cavity. Behind the nasal aperture, anterior nasal aperture, there are some small projections or partitions or small canopies. Now that shown here is the inferior nasal concha. We will see all of these in more specific detailed location in the next few imaging anatomy pictures. That's the inferior nasal concha. Likewise, right above it is the middle nasal concha. Remember, while inferior nasal concha is an individual bone, one of the small bones, the middle nasal concha is a part of the ethmoid bone. Next, here is a beautiful skull. I showed this in the previous part 2 discussion. Here we have removed a small portion of the frontal bone and the adjacent and the frontal sinus that is there, and it has been cut horizontally in such a way that the ethmoidal sinuses are visible on either sides of the nasal septum. I have already introduced the nasal septum earlier, and the two flashing arrows are the ethmoidal sinuses. Note, this is beautifully shown that these ethmoidal sinuses are lodged, sandwiched between the nasal cavity medially and the orbital cavity laterally. That means the ethmoidal sinus, let's say we take the right sinus, is sandwiched between the right nasal cavity and the right orbit. Likewise for the left. It's a very interesting slide. Next, immediately lateral to the nasal cavity are the maxillary sinuses. In fact, the wall, there's a wall that separates the lateral, the maxillary sinus laterally from the nasal cavity medially. And is in the upper part of that wall, there is a small opening. That's the maxillary hiatus opening into the middle meatus. Now, this is another helpful slide, although this is not strictly norma frontalis. This is only to supplement or improve your understanding. Here is a sagittal section, slightly parasagittal, either this side or that side of the septum, so that you can see the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. And in particular, you can actually see the two conchae, inferior and middle concha, in this particular photograph. A little higher up, the tiny lower edge of the superior nasal concha is also seen. Although I have not put a arrow mark on it, because we will see this in higher detail in another series. Next, behind the nasal cavity, okay, and immediately below the central part of the middle cranial fossa, or very particularly below the pituitary fossa, here is the pituitary gland, the flashing arrow is in this sphenoidal sinus. This sinus opens anteriorly into the nasal cavity. It opens anteriorly into the nasal cavity. Now, this is a MRI coronal section through the naso-orbital region. As I told you, we need to concentrate on a few photographs of imaging anatomy, because it's just not enough identifying it in a skull for osteology, but you should also be able to correlate it, successfully identify corresponding structures in a one plane X-ray, to the extent possible CT scan, MRI and other imaging modalities. Now here is a coronal section. You can see flashing that rectangle right in the middle is the bony septum, or I will just say septum of the nose, because this is a MRI scan. Then on either sides of the septum is the, seen in black, is the nasal cavity. And projecting from the lateral wall of the nasal cavity, here is the inferior nasal concha. Further lateral to it is the maxillary sinus. In fact, the lateral wall of the nasal cavity separates the maxillary sinus from the cavity of the nose. And it's very obvious that right above the maxillary sinus is the orbital cavity. Next, that's what I have shown. But more importantly, in between the nasal cavity and the orbital cavity, there is a small black area. Now that black area is the ethmoidal air sinus. That is the that's the flashing arrow. The arrow is in the ethmoidal sinus on the left side. On the right side, the flashing arrow is in the orbit. Now this is a very, very important slide. It's generally difficult to identify the ethmoidal air sinuses, but this is a very good coronal section to demonstrate it. Now this is not a coronal section. This is an MRI horizontal section through the lower nose. This is lower nose very particularly because, one, on either sides of the nasal septum, watch carefully, there's a long turbinate. This long turbinate is the inferior nasal concha. That means the level is low. Low in the sense, the level is below the orbit. Therefore, the cavity on either sides of this nasal cavity is the maxillary air sinus. I repeat, the cavity is the maxillary. At this level of the section, the ethmoidal sinus is too high and it is not visible. And the bone that you see in the septum here is the Omer bone. Please note this very carefully. Next. This is again a magnified view of a horizontal section MRI passing through the nasal cavity, but it is at a much higher level than what you saw in the previous slide. Much higher level because the orbital cavities are very well seen. In fact, the eyeball, the optic nerve is visible on both sides. And then on either sides of the septum are the nasal cavity, and beautifully shown, sandwiched between the orbital cavity and the nasal cavity are a group of, or a series of air-filled cavities. That whole thing collectively are referred to as ethmoidal air sinuses. In later discussion, where we give a detailed overview of the sinuses, we will classify the sinus into anterior, middle and posterior ethmoidal sinuses. But for the moment, let's collectively call them as ethmoidal sinuses. The take-home point of this slide in particular is the ethmoidal sinuses are sandwiched between the upper part of the nasal cavity and the orbit. Again, to recapitulate the point, the nasal septum and the cavity of the nose have been highlighted. The nasal septum, seen in white, is in the midline, exactly in the sagittal plane, and the cavity of the nose is the black area on either sides of this slide, septum. Now, as already mentioned, orbit and its contents, obviously here well seen, the eyeball and the optic nerve is clearly visible. Now, that was a overview of Norma frontalis part 3, and the area focused upon or concentrated upon is the nasal region. If you have any points for feedback, please feel free to write to me to this email baluvbs@yahoo.com, or this is hosted in YouTube, and in the YouTube blog right below the video, YouTube video, there is a lot of space available for the blog. There you can feel free to add your comments or feedback. This was a presentation from the anatomy department of St. John's Medical College, India. Similar to VBS Osteomed, that means osteology series of videos, we also have a set of about 75 histology videos also posted in the same channel. We have called it as VBS Histomed. You can go through these videos. They are generally meant for MBBS and similar courses. To a great extent, it can also be used for nursing, BPT. It can also be used for some of these allied health courses. Thank you.